Here we are again. Cheers to you guys, because we're doing another little Instagram live stream.
Guess what? You're in the next video.
Hey! What is that gigantic thing that Eric is holding in his hand?
Time to go ride. Kind of an awkward angle. Yeah, that ride was, actually, you know what? It was pretty fun. I do think, though, that fast riding is a different ballgame. When I ride fasted, I actually have more fun with my riding, so I may need to do that more often. Now it is about 1:30 in the afternoon, and I am going to go deadlift. I'm going to try to hit 415 today for a triple. I wish I could hit 410, but again, can't micro-load at my gym. So we're going to see what happens. I'm going to go probably get some food in before I go deadlift. I did hit 405 last week, fasted, which is crazy to me. It's a 20-pound PR. Yeah, guys, I don't know how it's going to be today. I don't know how it's going to go. I didn't really get a lot of sleep last night, and yeah, things have just been meh with me. So we'll see how it goes. By the way, everybody, when I said I wasn't gonna be preparing oatmeal in the same exact way, I kinda lied. But we do have pretzels, though. We do have pretzels. That is something I guess it's kinda new. All I'm missing now is some peanut butter.
Moments later.
I had to dig and I had to dig, but I found some peanut butter, guys. Now we can go deadlift. Well, that was pretty shitty, not gonna lie. So two shitty workouts in a, hold on, two poopy, no, sounds really terrible. Just two bad workouts in a row. So 395 felt like it was 600 pounds today. I don't know what happened. Yesterday was a terrible bench workout. Today was a pretty bad deadlift workout. So I figured it was right around the time too, and I made the decision already right after I pulled 395 for a single. I was like, you know what, it's been about six, I deload every 6 to 8 weeks anyways, normally. And I haven't taken a proper deload in a long, long time. So it's probably time for that. So now moving forward, I'm probably gonna deload for the rest of the week before I go on my trip, assuming that I still am gonna be going on my trip, and I think I am. Lifting heavy for as long as I have been, it's been a good, I think it's actually been over 8 weeks. I've been going full balls deep into this bulk I've been doing. Just say strength phase, I hate calling it bulk, but whatever. That being said, I expect all of you to call me a pussy right now. So feel free to pause the video and do what you wanna do. Say what you wanna say. I'm waiting. Okay, I'm gonna shut up now. See you guys in a little bit. Alrighty guys, so it's about 7 o'clock right now. And yeah, I figured, you know what? I'm almost done with my day. Got my bike back, had a pretty decent ride this morning. Didn't have a really good workout, but that's okay. I haven't really shown you guys
my crib yet. The rest of the crib is downstairs, but my room. Let me take you into my official quarters. La Casa de Electric. My native tongue that means house of electric.
That's it, guys. That's my studio right there. That is the king's bed where absolutely no magic happens.
The bed is comfortable. That's what I care about. Oh, shit. I'm gonna go pass out now and talk to you guys in a little bit.
A few moments later.
The next day.
Just going for a little ride and you end up at Krispy Kreme.
Reese's Peanut Butter Cup Donut.
All right, so I just finished up my Krispy Kreme video and I gotta go get my drone back.
All right, it's on.
Cool. All right, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Take care. Back in business.
Alrighty guys, so I just got back home from the store and I actually had to get a few things. Not a big haul by any means, but I haven't done one of these in a while, so I figured, you know what, I'll show you guys what I got.
Guys, I have never grabbed a cereal box so fast in my entire life. This is all new from Honey Bunches of Oats right here. We have pecan and maple brown sugar, so I'm going to be trying that out tonight for sure. After that, I had to get some bread. Got a little scrunched up there. Yeah, oh well. After that, I had to get some Diet 7-Up 2. Yum, 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 yum. And then some pears right there. Ranch cauliflower, which is really, really good. And then some snap peas, which I'll probably be doing a stir fry with tonight. And I'm actually switching over to this, which kind of, it's actually really, I don't know. I like this a lot better than the liquid sweetener that I usually use. Last but not least, some strawberries. So that is a little mini grocery haul for you guys. I'll see you in the next part of the video.
Moments later.
Alrighty guys, it's been a long time since I've done a formal cereal review. So I saw this box of cereal tonight in the store and I couldn't have grabbed it any quicker than I did. We have pecan and maple brown sugar honey bunches of oats. It just sounds absolutely amazing when you say it. Let's try this out. I have to be completely honest here guys, I've never been so excited to try honey bunches of oats before. Never so excited. The all new maple and pecan brown sugar honey bunches of oats. A glorious moment. Mother of Lord. It's so good. By the way, guys, it's very, very, very important to get your first impression of cereal with a complete dry spoonful or a few dry spoonfuls. Then you add in the milk. I have to say, guys, that the clusters in the cereal are absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. I mean, honestly, just look at that thing. That is a cluster of deliciousness right there. The maple is very, very prevalent in this cereal. And honestly, I'm loving every second of it. Now, I realize that this is the first cereal review I've ever done on my knees. But it's totally worth it for the epicness of the lighting. I'm gonna give this cereal an overall rating of 8.5 out of 10.
The next day.
Natural versus unnatural.
What's up, Eric the Electric? More traveling. There's always time to do more traveling.
Not natty one. Sometimes it's better to go to the dark side.
Thank you.
Alrighty, well, that's done and over with. That was my first, I guess, deload workout done. Wasn't even really a workout. I hit squats and everything for 175 pounds for five by five. Apart from that, I just did some leg pressing and various accessory work. I don't know what it is. I'm just not in a good mood at all today. I'm very, very tired, and I'm just not feeling like being in the gym or doing anything on camera or any of this, but I figured I'd just put this up there just to put it up there. I'm trying to like pinpoint the source of like why I feel shitty, and I don't know, I just don't feel good. Hopefully things do get better, but yeah guys, it's just, I guess you just have bad days. I'm just not feeling very positive about myself today, and I'm not feeling very motivated by really anything. It's only 3:30 in the afternoon, and I feel like I haven't done anything with my day, and I feel like every day is pretty much the same right now. I'm trying to motivate myself to do just more shit, and yeah, it's just, it's getting old. I need to get excited about my trip, and I haven't even started planning it yet. I feel like if I was excited about my trip and I was excited to get the hell out of San Diego, I would be already planning it, and I'd be planning all the stuff that I'm gonna do, but I'm not, because I don't get motivated to do stuff like that. I don't get motivated to do exciting stuff. I don't know, I'm just not gonna get really into it. Yeah, today is just one of those days, I guess.
The next day.
Coffee, coffee, and more coffee.
Well, I am actually about to go on a nice little ride with a friend that I haven't seen in forever. Therefore, we power up with some coffee. I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Wait, you forget your GoPro at home? Say what's up. Wave, say hi.
Well, we're all done. That was pretty insane. Very low key casual ride. Got to ride with a friend that I haven't seen since high school, which is really dope. I am going to probably go home, get food, and go to the gym like I usually do on Fridays. Exciting, exciting, exciting. Bye.
One of the best things after a ride. Hydration. Now I just have to eat real food. Yeah, sometimes I eat toast dry. It's just better that way. Only sometimes.
Alrighty guys, well that shoulder workout is done /deload workout. It is Friday right now, and I got done with an awesome ride this morning, and you know what guys, I filmed a few sets, but I'm not really gonna film that much more. It's pretty boring right now for me, not gonna lie. I am more focused on acclimating I'm about a week in, so I've pretty much been acclimated to the new living situation that I'm in. A lot of you have asked why I moved back in with my mom. I've said many, many times that, you know, living by yourself, especially when you don't do well by yourself, over a long period of time, it's just not conducive to a good, positive, mental, psychological state. That's just the way I feel. So you know what, I felt like it would be better that I, at least before I moved into my next apartment, at least just took some time to see what it's like to live around people again, and it's been doing a lot better for me, or has worked a lot better for me. Anyways, everybody, I did what needed to be done this week. I had to set aside my ego, and I had to really just realize that I've been really lifting heavy. I've been just being crazy in the gym for the past 6 to 8 weeks, and so when you lift heavy for that long, you do need to let your muscles recover, and you need to, that's how to get over plateaus, really, is to, take deloads when you need to take them. Again, ego is not everything. Put it aside and lift light for a little bit and do what needs to be done, and you'll get back on track. I'm hoping that next week will go a little bit better. I do have a pretty sick concert coming up, which I'm gonna go to. I get to go see Metallica. I'm stoked about that. And yeah, I am going to be preparing. I'm getting my car fixed. So I'm preparing for my trip that I'm going to be taking Still don't know where I'm going yet. Who cares? I might just pack a bag and throw it in my car and go. Anyways, guys, I really hope you guys have enjoyed the video so far. If you did, let me know what you like down below. Check me out on Patreon if you haven't already. It's a great way for you guys to support us YouTube creators that take time to make YouTube videos. Follow me on social media if you haven't already. Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram, you know the drill. Thanks again for watching the video, everybody, and go right ahead.